In 2004, a series of earthquakes began on the very northern edge of the North Island of New Zealand at the town of Matata. Over the next decade, hundreds of earthquakes struck underneath the town, which at first were thought to be related to a deep fault. However, these earthquakes were too numerous in nature and did not seem to dissipate at the rates expected given the area's geologic setting. In truth, all of these earthquakes were not caused by faulting, but rather an intrusion of magma in the crust right underneath the town. As the magma pushed upwards, it generated additional earthquakes. Since 1950, this ongoing intrusion of magma, which has moved in phases, has pushed up a wide swath of ground totaling 400 square kilometers by as much as 40 centimeters or 16 inches. It is suspected that this intrusion of magma will eventually reach the surface, producing New Zealand's newest volcano. So, why is magma intruding into this section of New Zealand in the first place? To the east of the North Island is a tectonic plate boundary where the Pacific plate is colliding with the Australian plate. Some of the subducted crust from this collision then melts and migrates upwards, resulting in a series of volcanoes. However, in this section of New Zealand, subduction has been ongoing for long enough that it caused a section of overlying crust to thin. As a result, hot material from the mantle rushed upwards to fill the empty space, resulting in a rift zone. This rift zone is referred to as the Taupo Volcanic Zone and is slowly spreading apart to the east and west. Every year, this zone expands by 8 millimeters, and the town of Matata just happens to be located on the far western edge of this region. Thus, it only recently joined the Taupo Volcanic Zone, which has allowed for an intrusion of magma to occur in the crust underneath the town. Scientists have measured the amount of magma underneath the town to be enough to fill 80,000 Olympic swimming pools. Another way of describing that figure is 0.2 cubic kilometers of magma. While that is still quite a large volume of magma, there might be even more present. We have yet to estimate the amount of molten rock present offshore of the island, so this magma reservoir is likely larger than first thought. Regardless, all of this material is unlikely to form a new volcano in our lifetime. The magma is currently located at a depth of 9.5 kilometers or 6 miles and is moving at a very slow rate. 9 times out of 10, intrusions of magma such as the one underneath the town never reach the surface and instead solidify underground, forming what is called a pluton. If the molten rock was to erupt on the surface, it would form a new complex of rhyolite lava domes. However, since magma takes a longer time to cool underground, it is most likely to form granite rock with large crystals of feldspar. If this intrusion of magma was to indeed eventually create a brand new volcano, it would likely begin erupting several hundred to several thousand years from now. However, while the uplift is occurring, there is a threat of magnitude 5 and 6 earthquakes occurring underneath the town, which could cause significant damage. As a final note, the intrusion of magma underneath Matata is not the only such body of molten rock in an unexpected location. Other unusual magma chambers are located beneath the town of Socorro in New Mexico and far beneath Lake Tahoe on the California-Nevada border. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my new patron Peter Lemon for supporting this channel.